You may or you may not know it, but I'm definitely sure you have used it more than once in your life, or even more than once in a day. What am I talking about? Stick around to find out. Welcome to another exciting episode of Technology for All Academy, an academy that teaches information communication technology for free. To mention but a few, we have Cisco and MicroTik series, and we'll be doing other vendor series in the future. For those who don't know me, my name is Thabang Makube, the founder of Technology for All Academy. I know most of you are watching this lesson on your mobile devices, such as cell phones and tablets, which use wireless technology. It might be via mobile service providers such as MTN, Vodacom, Cell C, and many more. Or it might be via Wi-Fi. And some of you may be watching via personal computers or smart TVs, which may also be using Wi-Fi or wired network via Ethernet cable. And all you had to do was to type your security credentials and you were able to access the internet or this lesson. But I'm here to tell you that there's a lot more than username and password involved to make this request a success. There are a lot of protocols involved for you to watch this lesson. And one of those protocols is DHCP, which is our topic for today. We are going to learn what is a DHCP, how does a DHCP work, and how to configure a DHCP. So what is a DHCP? Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol. It's a protocol used to list parameters such as IP address, subnet mask, gateway, DNS server, and many more to our host or client. When we talk about host or client, we talk about devices such as your cell phone, tablet, personal computers, smart TVs, IP cameras, and many more. They don't really need a static IP address to function. And in this world of Internet of Things, it will really be painful to configure a static IP address unless you get paid per device configured. Those of you who have internet installed in your homes, whether wireless or wired, your internet service provider probably included a router that can also act as a switch, a firewall, a DNS server, and a DHCP server. So how does DHCP work? DHCP uses a process we call DOR. The host will send a discover message looking for a DHCP server that can list or offer an IP address. If there's more than one DHCP server, the first DHCP server that will offer an IP address will be the one considered and the rest will be dropped. So the considered DHCP server will send an offer message which will include the parameters that the DHCP server is offering to our client or a host. If our host is interested or agrees with our DHCP server, it will send a request message requesting the IP address that the DHCP server offered. And our DHCP server will send an acknowledge message to our host to acknowledge that it gives it or it lists the IP address. So in order for me to show that process, I'm going to use my home internet and the program that's called Wireshark so that we can see how does a DHCP work. A practical example of DORA. Let me start my DHCP practical example by opening Wireshark. And while Wireshark is busy opening, I'll go to my search and then type cmd so that I can open my command prompt, and I'll give the command ipconfig/all. On the information that we got from ipconfig, I want to show you this DHCP enabled. We can see it says yes, meaning we are using DHCP to get our parameters such as IP address, subnet mask, default gateway, DNS server, and then As we can see, let me show you everything. IPv4 address, it's 10.10.10.253. Subnet mask /24, which is 255.255.255.0. And then there's our lease obtain and lease expire. That's the time that we got it and the time that our lease will expire. Our default gateway is 10.10.10.1. And our DHCP server is 10.10.10.1. So meaning our router is acting as our DHCP server. And DNS servers, we have two, we have primary and secondary. The primary one is 102.66.255.10. And the secondary is 102.66.255.11. Okay, now let me minimize my command prompt because I'm still going to use it again. And then I'll start capturing packets on my network interface card. And then now let me go back to my command prompt. And right now I'm going to give the command ipconfig/release to release my DHCP parameters. Okay, ipconfig/release, enter. And then let me minimize my command prompt and stop my capture. And then I'll filter my capture to DHCP, enter. As we can see, the information DHCP release, meaning it's our release message. And then let's analyze it. Internet protocol version 4, it's from our source, is 10.10.10.253, which is our client. And destination is 10.10.10.1, which is our DHCP server. Now let me open user datagram. And as you can see, our source port is port 68, which is our DHCP client. And destination port is port 67, which is our DHCP server. Let me go down. Client IP address, as you can see, 10.10.10.253. DHCP server identifier, it's 10.10.10.1. And then right now, what I want to do, I'm going to go back to my command prompt and I'm going to give the command ipconfig/renew so that we can get our new parameters or the parameters that we want, meaning our IP address, subnet mask, default gateway, DNS servers, from our DHCP server. But before I can give the command, I'll go back to Wireshark and I'll start the new capture. Continue without saving. Yes, I'm going to continue without saving. So right now we're going to analyze the packets of DORA. We are doing the practical of DORA. Continue without saving. Let me go back to my command prompt and give the command ipconfig/renew, enter. Okay, let's wait for it. And we got our IP address is 10.10.10.253, subnet mask /24, default gateway 10.10.10.1. Okay, let me minimize. And then let's go back to our Wireshark. And then we can see the first message is from 0.0.0.0, meaning it's our client doesn't have an IP address. It's sending a message out there for any DHCP server that can offer an IP address. And if there's more than one, the first one to send or to offer an IP address parameters will be the one that's considered. And the destination, as you can see, is 255.255.255.255, which is a broadcast message or broadcast address. Protocol DHCP, info DHCP, discover. And then if you go down, you can see it's DORA, DORA, which is discover, offer, request, acknowledge, not DORA the Explorer. So if we can analyze, we can see internet protocol, as I've said, it's from 0.0.0 to destination broadcast address. And then we are using UDP, source port, it's port 68, it's from our client. And destination port is port 67 is going to our DHCP server. The second message we have source port being 10.10.10.1, which is our DHCP server, and the message is going to 255.255.255.255, which is a broadcast address. And then, as we can see, right now the source port is port 67, which is our DHCP server. And this destination port is port 68, which is our client. And if we go down, we can see client IP address is 0.0.0.0. And this is the IP address that we've been offered, 10.10.10.253. Next server IP address, our server is 10.10.10.1. And our cheddar or our MAC address is ending with 1FBD. As we saw, our MAC address, or if we can go back, we can see that our MAC address is ending with 1FBD. Okay, let me minimize my command prompt. And then option 54, we can see DHCP server identifier is 10.10.10.1. Let's go to our request message. Our request message, you can see source port is from 68, which is our client, to destination port of 67, which is our server. And then as you can see, the message is from 0.0.0.0 to 255.255.255.255, which is a broadcast address. The parameters will almost be the same. It's the requested IP address, we've requested it. So the DHCP is offering us the IP address that we requested, meaning we send a discover message looking for an IP address and the DHCP send an offer. If we are happy with the offer, like right now, we are happy with the offer, we send a request requesting the IP address that the DHCP server offered us. When you go to our last message, as we can see, it's from 10.10.10.1 to 255.255.255.255. Source MAC, it's our server. Source IP is our server, and destination IP is broadcast IP. Source port, the server. Destination port is our client. And as you can see, type of message is acknowledgement, meaning our server is acknowledging or confirming that it's giving us the IP address that we requested. Now for our DHCP protocol configuration, we are going to use our packet tracer lab test that we have been using. And in our lab test, we are going to configure our main building router as our DHCP server. And the pools that we are going to create, you are going to create pool for VLAN 1, VLAN 10, VLAN 20, and 192.168.1.0 network. For VLAN 1, VLAN 10, and VLAN 20, we are going to exclude the first 99 IP address, meaning .1 to .99. And for 192.168.1.0 network, we are going to exclude our first IP address, .1. Secondly, we are going to configure our DHCP pool for those networks that I spoke about, and we are going to configure SB2, our supporting building 2, one of the interface as a DHCP client, and we're also going to configure a relay agent. So without wasting time, let me start with my main building router. Okay, I'll open the command line. As we know, our password by now is 123456. The password that we have been using so far, 123456, enter. And then I'll type in enable to get into privilege mode. Password 123456, enter. And then conf t, which is configure terminal, to get into global configuration. And for me to exclude my IP address, the command that I need to give is IP DHCP excluded address, then it start with 10.10.1.1 and to 10.10.1.99, enter. And notice that we are still into configuration mode. And let's do the same for VLAN 10. Also the first 99 IP addresses, and then hit the up arrow so that we can do the same command for VLAN 20. So the first 99 IP addresses, and for 192.168.1.0 network, we said we exclude one IP address, 192.168.1.1. That's the IP address that we exclude. And then now that we are finished with the excluded addresses, we're gonna configure our DHCP pools. I'm going to start with VLAN 1 DHCP pool. And to get into DHCP configuration mode, we have to type the command IP DHCP pool and then make it VLAN 1. You can give it any name. I gave it VLAN 1. And then as you can see right now, we are inside the DHCP configuration mode. And then let me start by configuring my network scope, which is going to be network 10.10.1.0 network, subnet mask 255.255.255.0, enter. So in that network scope that I've just created right now, we know that the first 99 IP addresses won't be part of our scope. They are excluded from being leased by DHCP. They are not part of our DHCP server. Okay, I'll also configure the DNS server. And then for DNS server, let's use the Google DNS server, which is 8.8.8.8. Enter. And domain name server, let's make it tech4acads.com, which is technology for all academy.com. Enter. And then default route, it's 10.10.1.1. Enter. So now let me also give the same command, create the next pool, IP DHCP pool. I'll create for VLAN 10 right now. Enter. Our default router will be 10.10.10.1. enter. And then domain name still the same as VLAN 1, DNS server the same as VLAN 1. And then we have to specify our network for VLAN 10, which is going to be 10.10.10.0 network. Enter. And then now let me create a pool for VLAN 20 and just hit the up arrow so that I can give the same configuration as VLAN 1. Just that now we are doing it for VLAN 20. DNS server, yes. Domain name server, default route 10.10.10.20.1. enter. Last but not least, we have to configure DHCP pool. Let me make it SB1. I'll name it SB1, SB1 to SB2. That's the name of my pool. Enter. And for network, I'm going to give it 192.168.1.0 network with subnet mask 255.255.255.252/30. enter. And that's the only two command that I'm going to give for that DHCP pool. Now let me end it, the configuration, and then give the command write so that I can save my configuration. And now for us to see the commands that we already configured, I'll give the command show run pipe section DHCP. Enter. And then as we can see, those are the address that are excluded. And then we created VLAN 1, we have network, default router, DNS server and domain name server. IP DHCP pool VLAN 10, the same, network, default router, DNS server and domain name, VLAN 20 and SB1 to SB2. Let me open my PC on VLAN 1, go to command prompt, and then I'll type ipconfig so that we can check our IP address. And then as you can see, we already have an IP address, which is 10.10.1.101 from our DHCP server. But then if you go to VLAN 10 or VLAN 20, we will see that we don't have an IP address from our DHCP server. Let me type the same command, IP config, enter. And as I've said, we can see the address that we have. It's 169.254.34.199, meaning it's a PIPA address. It doesn't go anywhere. It's a Windows address. It's a dummy address. So for us to get an IP address from our DHCP server, we have to do something. And the thing that we need to do is to create a relay agent. And to do that, let me go to our switch and then I'll go to command line, press enter, password 123456, enter, enable, enter, password 123456, enter, and then let's give the command show IP interface brief, enter. Then what I want you to see is that we have our SVIs for VLAN 10 and VLAN 20 is 10.10.10.1 and .20.1. Those are our SVIs. So now let me type conf t to get into global configuration mode. And I'll give the command interface VLAN 10, enter, so that we can get in our SGI interface. And then the command for relay agent, it's IP helper, IP helper address. And then we have to give the address of our DHCP server. And our DHCP server in our instance is router 1 or our main building router. And the address is 10.10.1.1. You are giving that IP address to the interface that's going to be your relay agent. In my case, my interface VLAN 10 is going to be my relay agent for VLAN 10. Enter. And then I'll also apply the same configuration for VLAN 20. Interface VLAN 20 and IP helper 10.10.1.1, enter. Now let me minimize. Okay, and then if we go back and give the same command again, IP config, let's see what will happen. Okay, as you can see, we don't have an IP address again. Let me give IP config /renew. Enter. Then let's wait for it. And as you can see right now, we were able to get an IP address from our DHCP server, which is 10.10.10.103, and we got it with the help of our relay agent. We must remember that broadcast address are meant to be on a single network. A broadcast address, it never leaves, or a router blocks a broadcast address. So that's why we need a relay agent to help us, because our DHCP server in this instance is centralized. It's on another network. Because when a DHCP client is looking for a DNS server, it sends a broadcast message, which is a discover message. So that's why we need a relay agent, so that a relay agent can act on our behalf. So when the message go to our server, it will go with the IP address of the relay agent as a source IP address and destination IP address as the IP address of our DHCP server. And when our DHCP server make an offer, it will use its IP address as a source IP, and the destination IP address, it will be our relay agent. Okay, as we have seen, now we saw that we got an IP address, even if we can go to .20, okay, IP config, enter, and we already, you can see we got an IP address. Let me make IP config /all, and then as you can see, tech4acad.com, there it is. We can see our DHCP server. We can see our DNS server. It's also there. Those are the things that I configured on my main building router. Okay, let me minimize. And then now I'm going to go to SB1. Okay, press enter. Password 123456. Enter. Enable. Password 123456. Enter. Let's give show IP interface brief. We can see our interface and their IP addresses. Then let me go into global configuration mode, and I'm going to create relay agent for 192.168.1.0 network, and the interface that I'm going to use is interface gig 0/1. Enter IP helper address 10.10.1.1. Enter. Then I'll exit. Okay, exit and write to save my configuration. Can't lose it right now. Then let me go to SB2, command line, enter, password 123456, enter, enable to get into privilege mode, enter, password 123456, enter, and then I'll give the command, show IP interface brief. We can see our interfaces and the IP address. And right now let me go into global configuration mode and interface gig 0/1. Enter, and I'm gonna give the command no IP address. Enter. That command is for us to remove the IP address from our interface. Okay, let's do show IP interface brief, and then as you can see, we don't have an IP address anymore. You can see it's unassigned. And now let me give the command IP address DHCP. Enter. And now let's give the command do show IP interface brief. Enter. And then as you can see, our IP address right now, the method that we got the IP address, it's saying DHCP, meaning our interface gigabit 0/1 is acting as a DHCP client. So we have configured our DHCP pools. We excluded the IP addresses that we needed to exclude. We configured our relay agents. And we also configured our DHCP client. And with that said, I hope this lesson was informative and I hope you enjoyed it. If you enjoyed the lesson, please share with someone you also think will also benefit from this video. And don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification button so that you can be notified whenever we drop a lesson like this one. Love and leave you. Have a blessed day. Thank you.